and bird land high in the sky up above. High in the sky up above. High in the sky up above.
Right now, and it's almost like a video diary, like a video journal, because it's just like it's too much, right? Like, it's too real. Like, I tried so hard to make sure that I didn't like pull like the beauty YouTuber card and sit on the floor with a hoodie and no makeup crying. Like, I tried so hard to make sure, like, I had makeup on, I had like a cute little top on, had my background, like, we're being professional today. I'm just terrified of seeming like a victim. I'm terrified of saying the wrong things, of people just, you know, picking this video apart because I know what's gonna happen. I know that it comes with the territory, of course. Like, I get all of that, but I'm just really scared. I really am. Let's be honest with you guys. It's hard for me to say that because I'm sorry, guys. I know that I'm not, like, supposed to cry. And I'm going to try my best to edit any, like, tears out, of course, because that's not the message I want to get across. But the reason I didn't film this video earlier, well, one of the reasons is because of this. Is because I didn't want to get on camera and I didn't want to sit here and cry and be like, oh, my God, like, I don't want to do that. But I'm having a hard time controlling the fact that tears are coming to my eyes. But please do not in any way think I'm doing that for attention or to play the victim, because that's not at all what's going on. It's just kind of hard to control right now. The purpose of today's video is just to get on here and try to get myself back into a mental headspace where I can just get back to doing what I love, which is makeup tutorials. Like, that's my real passion. I mean, I want to say my real passion. It's one of my strongest passions, that along with developing makeup. I wanted to create and own my own cosmetic brand since I worked at MAC Cosmetics at Woodfield Mall in Chicago when I was 20 years old, which was 9 years ago. And that's always been my dream. And that's why this whole thing has been so hard for me, because I completely failed. Like, I say it every day and I'm still just like, I choke on those words. Like, my launch was a failure. It failed. It sucked. I spent so much time working on that brand. I spent so much time hyping people up. I was so excited. I was so confident. And honestly, I was so confident that I was almost cocky, to be quite honest, because I was just like, this is going to be the best thing that people ever seen. The best lipsticks the market has ever seen. Like, I was working with the best lab, with the best people. I spent all this money. I was just like, this is amazing. Like, I was so confident to the point of cockiness. There's so many rumors out there, which I'm not even going. I'm not going to address them. Like, I'm not here for that, because if I start to address the rumors, I would be making a video that's 2 hours long. I'm not going to do that. I know that some people have speculations. I did not have a quality control team big enough to handle what I was doing at all, and I totally messed up, and the fact that I had to mess up and show my ass in front of millions of people who love me and trust me sucks. But still, that's not why I, like, went black and deleted my accounts. It's not because I was embarrassed. We'll get to that in a minute. That's not at all the reasoning. But I just say I'm sorry. It's so important to me that you guys know how sorry I am and how embarrassed I am. Like, this has just been shocking. It's been shocking. I messed up in more than one way. I was way too overconfident in my launch, and I was not enough involved in quality control, and I overhyped it for you guys for what ended up happening. I trusted the wrong people. I did a lot of things that I should not have done, and I just feel terrible for anybody who received a lipstick that wasn't perfect. That's why I gave every single person a refund, and people were so sweet not wanting to accept the refund and giving their refunds to charities and just doing such kind things. It was so sweet, but I just honestly, I could not sleep at night. I could not sleep. Just seeing what I was seeing online, I was just so disturbed and so just out of my mind, you guys, and I'm going to open up later when it's a better time, because now isn't the time for me to sit here and talk to you about what I've gone through the past couple of weeks. But when the time is right, I really do want to sit down and open up with you guys and explain to you what's been going on, because you know that I am the first person to, I want to make everybody feel like they're not alone, like they have a safe place to come to talk to me, to be here on my channel, you know, to be a part of this family. Well, there's a bug flying through my house. Again, a later time. With all that being said, I am beyond grateful for everything that I have learned throughout this process. It's been a rough ride, but I am honestly grateful for it. I'm not going to sit here and talk about every single thing that I have done to right my wrongs, because at the end of the day, it is my brand. You know, everything that I do is confidential. I don't have to share it with the entire world, but just so you guys have like a little insight, I have fired so many people and I have hired so many people. In this past month, I have built an entire new quality control team. I have brought on several different people for all different things. And that's why I love social media. I know that people think that I love social media because I was running away, I was hiding, and I get it. I completely understand it. That's exactly what it looks like. That's what I would think too. But the reason I had to get away from social media and just fully delete it is because at that point, I had refunded everybody there, every single penny I had spent. I was humiliated, I was embarrassed, and it was time for me to start picking things up and putting the pieces back together and rebuilding. You know, as a CEO, as a boss, as an owner of a brand, you don't get to just sit back and be like, meh, like you have to start rebuilding, right? Everybody wants to be the boss. My whole life, I always wanted to be the boss. I was just like, oh my God, can you imagine being the boss, being a manager? And like, when it actually happens, you're just like, okay, this is not what I wanted. You know, it's like, it's a lot. It's more than what you think. It's not like wearing Christian Louboutin heels every single day and Valentino marching to the office. Yes, I run shit. It's a lot. It's aggressive. And I definitely was not prepared. And I definitely was very ignorant in this entire process of thinking what it would actually be. And for that, I am grateful. It sounds so weird, but I'm grateful for the fact that this happened, because I immediately got to learn such incredible lessons on being a boss, on running a company, on how to talk to people, on how to do all of this. And I'm so grateful for that in this process. Sorry, my words, my mind is all over the place. But the reason I had to leave social media is because I was sitting on the couch one night and I was just driving myself insane. I was just watching articles and I was just watching, you know, people nonstop talking. I actually did really good about one thing, and I didn't watch any gossip videos because I knew that there's nothing in there that's going to help me in this or feed me.
Hello, everybody. I have noticed a certain little person is back on her channel. Miss Jacqueline Hill. And what I want to say is I'm pretty proud of her. I'm honestly proud of her for owning her shit, owning her mistakes, And you know what? I honestly will say, because this is not a James Charles incident, that I would forgive her for her mistakes, because we are all human and we all fuck up. But I just don't like James Charles, so there's no forgiving him. So, she basically owns everything and apologizes for it. And to be honest, I get where she comes from, why she had to deactivate her social media. And I hope the best for her and her brand. I hope now that she's fired everybody and has rehired better people, that everything comes together better and she starts taking good advice from good CEOs who knows the ins and outs of what it is to have a makeup brand. I actually believe that was a learning lesson, and I hope when Jacqueline Cosmetics comes for another launch that she does amazing. And I do believe that she will. Everybody has to learn. Everybody has to learn from past mistakes. And obviously she has. And I cannot wait to see what else she comes out with. So that is it for today's video.